Right, we started. So that's our interview with Tatiana, right?
Yes.
Hi. All right. So can you introduce yourself and what do you do?
Absolutely. Okay. So I'm hello. I am Tatiana. I do angelic readings with cards. I also do past life regressions. And I'd like to define myself as a soul doctor, really.
How long did you do that and when did you discover that?
Well, as anything in life, there's a story to me and in my progress. I'd say I've been intuitive and psychic all my life, and aren't we all? Now, knowing things about people and myself were coming through nighttime dreams all my life since I was a child. But really, this work that I'm doing consciously right now started around 2010. That was my breaking period. When everything I knew just fell apart. I was in college, traditional school work. Everything just became a stranger to me. I felt I did not belong. And also, a second interesting thing has happened. I felt that I pick up other people's emotions. I wasn't able to define at that time what's happening, but I felt I had to cry and release things. I had too many questions and no answers. And that's where the journey has started for me. Meeting interesting people, centers on spirituality, I got all my answers. I was impressed. First year in 2010 up till 11, I wrote 25 questions that were unusual, deep questions. I got, after 24 questions, 23 answers by the end of the year. I was like, wow, check mark, done. And that's how my journey has started.
Do you have teachers?
Absolutely. And I would say every person that met me on my path is absolutely my teacher. Some were the mentors that I was drawn to intuitively. For example, on the back of me, I have Theta Healing classes with Vayana Steibel. This is not a promotion or commercial of that particular modality, but most definitely it pushed me forward even more into self-discovery and who I am and more gifts I have to offer now to others.
What kind of angelic realms can you describe? What is tangible? What you can share? How do you go there and what do you do there?
I would put it even in this broader perspective, if I may. Basically what has happened, I now realize I'm a multidimensional being and always been, but until particular time, like I said, 2010, I did not had that realization. Now I do. And with an angelic realm, there are actually many multiple unending realms. Angelic realm is only one of them, if I may say. Even within angelic realm, there are different layers of that. And it's not something that exists outside in a way. It's concurrently existing. With angelic, since you've asked me particularly with angelic realm, is one of the existing multiple, in multi-universe, multiple realms. It's just sort of like a frequency. And on that frequency, particular beings exist. In a sense, in all totalities, it's almost like they are us, and we are them. And anything that else that exists also is us. It's just, let's say this, on a frequency of 300, and I'm element H2O, I'm solid ice. At 500, I'm water, but movable, more flexible. And at 750, I'm air. Same with that. Angelic realm is another expression of self, only on a higher resonating frequency. Does that make sense?
Of course. What are your favorite angels?
Oh, my goodness. There are as many as us, it's not many. And again, I started with Raphael. Mm-hmm. He was the one who stubbornly came forward through colors. Mm-hmm. Emerald green has occurred, and my favorite color is blue. And I was like, I had a night light that switched colors. It has some sensor inside. It has red in it, purple, emerald green, blue. And one day, right after a few days I got it, it stuck on green. I was stubborn, doing kids tantrum. I'm like, why on green when I love all colors, let's say that. But blue is my favorite. Why green? I felt something was communicating with me. I'm very conscious. Rational, skeptical too. It's almost, but I felt deeply something is playing a game with me. And I'm like, okay, you're talking to yourself. So experimentally, because there is a scientist in me, I took the light to my friends and I said, I'm gonna just stop using you if you're not gonna either start rotating my colors or at least switch to blue or something. And guess what? But I was too curious in this game. Too curious, too experimental. At my friend's place, the colors start shifting, all of them. Ooh, and then I was even more curious. I'm like, let me bring it back to my place and plug it in. And I plugged it in, and guess what happened then? Well, blue color appeared, and I was like, ha ha. And then green lasted a bit longer. Mm-hmm. Ratio 1 to 1.5, okay? Just to prove the point that I am saying that something is trying to find level to communicate with me, and it says, I will communicate with you if you just open up simply and follow the symbol signs. And so that's how it started with me with angels, and in particular Raphael. And then there were more and more and more. Shekinah, and there are Tree of Life holders, and Metatron. It's like mother, father type of presence.
Yeah, Metatron is my favorite.
There you are. He's the one who's into information and guidance and Akashic records, I would say, probably connected. I don't want to sound brainy here because I know nothing really.
Are you doing science too?
Science?
Yeah.
At heart. Never really by work, by trade, and I haven't done science, but always been highly fascinating and definitely admire some of the known scientists, such as Einstein is my favorite. Because he had heart, many quotes that he has about love and family. And I'm like, yes, that's the attitude. If you want to receive more gifts, information on new inventions, then it got to be through heart. So,
I love Einstein too. So how do you get the messages? Are they textual, voices, or visuals, or information?
Okay. At the beginning for me, I literally saw standing poles of energy spread. I would feel them most definitely. And that was it. Then I got a bunch of different cards. They are tools that can be used, don't have to be, but used. So it gives something for brain to calm down. So it needs to prove constantly. And so spirit says, sure, well, let's use the cards then. And then I also done what's called automatic writing, when you just grab a piece of paper. You could do it on a computer too by typing, and then pen, relax, have an intention that it's safe and you protect it. You can invoke an Archangel Michael if you wish, or Metatron. Ideally through Source Creator, because it is totality of all that is, even beyond angelic realm. And then just say anything that it's meant to come. And you can start writing hello and then joke and then see what comes. You might doodle pictures, symbols, doesn't have to be words. So that's another way of communicating with angels that is simple and accessible to anyone, especially children, because I think they naturally do it anyway.
So now when you get the question, how do you get the answer?
Yes, through the card readings in particular, I would have, for example, there's a 10 card spread that shows where the person is in terms of their mental state, emotional state. It actually shows each separate state of being. And then it would show the challenge immediately, like where you're stuck, what are you creating, what kind of trouble you're self-creating. And so it's just, maybe if we shift this, it's going to just disappear. And it's simple as that. So using tools, cards, and looking at the pictures, which is fun always. They're colorful and fun to play with. There are some messages on modern cards. Oh gosh, much easier than it used to be in caveman day. You can read it off of it, as easy as that. And feeling, does that resonate? If it's comfortable, yes, great. It also, if you really resist something strongly, also it's probably yes, because why do you resist it so much? Because you don't want to accept the part of yourself? So that's the way I do it.
Are you also into extraterrestrials, into aliens?
Yeah, I mean, in multi-universe, Pleiadians, Arcturians, there are many, many races within Milky Way galaxies in different realms. Lyrans, for example, about half a year ago, I fell asleep and just in my spirit self, was in Lyran dimension, that is 11th, 12th dimension. Not to, again, put too much emphasis on numbers and all that stuff is not important. It felt everybody were in unity consciousness there. It felt there were same looking beings like us people, men and women, and there were children, but they all were like child state. There were no need to find a mate and be coupled up, this insecurity, oh, I must have my wife and husband and kid. This, everybody just were. And they, and for whatever reason, it also gave me the analogy, the visuals in that dream that everybody loved water, which is a symbol of consciousness. They're so connected like water. It's one, while being experiencing the individual self, completely telepathic through the heart and self-beingness, and just very nicely connected, not worrying about anything. The moment I woke up, come back to this dimension reality, self-experience, I felt, actually it lasted almost all day. And then I'm like, and then it started because of the realm that also is here. I start feeling like losing it, like it would, the wave of that goodness would go away. And I'm like, what do I do? The brain asked, hungry for that goodness. And I'm like, put any natural sounds of falling water, waterfall. Yes, the brain wants complex super solutions, but it's as simple as that sound of natural water falling down, like rain is a bit different, or ocean. That also has soothing healing, by the way, very good for insomnia and all that stuff. But falling brook, like a brook water, that's it. You're going to be instantaneously, internally connected with the higher self expression and dimensions. And then watch what else happens.
Do you speak any alien languages?
Haven't channeled with any. Actually, I would have to say yes. It would come through sounds, toning, and sudden needs to make, it like just comes. It would not sound like, as anything that sounds like sentences and phrases as in our language, but it would be, it's almost like, it would come off. And you would feel immediately good, like something had been really self-healing. It's more of a toning and making sounds rather than precise words that mean something mental. It has nothing to do to mental, but yes, I would have to say yes. It's freaky, it gives me the shivers right now to admit that.
Do you channel?
I have, aftermatic writing is part of channeling. Uh-huh. And through that, I did a little bit of mediumship. I've channeled my grandfather, who by the way is Russian, and he said in Russian language, I'll say it first quickly in Russian and then translate, Внуча, утро вечера мудренее, which means go to sleep. Why are you pushing for things to happen? Go to sleep because early morning is always better than late at night. And he drew pictures of, flying helicopters, we call them, and at least that's how I know, from maple trees. In those pictures, I wondered, what's such a meaning of that basic picture? And then I remember back to my grandfather is no longer alive, obviously, that's why Javier communicated this way. And on his place where he used to live, there were two grand, huge maple trees. And he's like, remember how it was back then, at that time, when you were little? And I'm like, wow, it was really dear to my heart, that type. So, channeling. So, ooh.
Yes.
Channeling spirits, huh? And it's interesting.
Just photograph it.
It's interesting that when I just channeled Gabrielle, uh-huh, maybe 2 days ago or so, I got the image of owl, and now, what a cute queen. It's very, very, I've seen, I'm like, wow, that looks familiar.
It happens all the time.
Yeah.
We were driving today, and Gabriel just came, like, Gabriel.
Really?
It was a sign on the street.
Wow. Well, so, like you see, take it or leave it, whatever you make of it, it is. I take it back. Maybe there were times I tried to communicate things to others. I'm like, until I realize it's not my part. Everybody has their own space, timing, understanding level, and it's all good. It's perfect as it is. It's like a rainbow of different colors. I've had different shades, and it keeps on changing, and who knows what's next.
Did any confirmations come to you, the ones which you kind of really can share that something happened was like pure miracle, pure message, other than things which you already described.
Okay. A message.
Like, you know, now the old just fell down and it reminded us about Gabriel, anything like that.
Would you like something in particular from angelic realm or any ascended masters, anything of value that I find?
Yeah, anything which comes to mind.
Of value in general. Okay, because many, many, many things have happened. Well, confirmations personal to me, I'll just quickly do that. I would hear the voice saying that somebody would cut my tire and that happened. the person didn't cut the tires, they just let the air out in two tires. And I had a flat tire again in a really bad neighborhood in dark time, and there was a man who came to me to help with a tire, and he had Om tattoo on his hand. And it's like, it was really, so many examples, there are countless. At this point, I don't write them down anymore. By the way, quick tip, whenever you go on a travel and drive or just go for a walk, ask for protection, never hurts. Just say, please protect me, my vehicle, bike, whatever you're on, and us together, triple. If you're not inside of it, it works.
I start a big travel on 19th and I ask for protection.
Excellent. Excellent. It's not necessary that you're here to be attacked or anything, but it just gives you extra comforting, extra cushioning. You feel like good, you're not alone, you're together, you've been guided. Even if you go for a random drive and then kind of choose to get lost, then you want to be done with yourself being lost and GPS, nothing works. Ask to be guided. They will travel you and actually going to show you how to get any place you need or home. That's amazing.
Have you seen visually the in a real angel in the room or real alien in the room or someone close
by? I also like drawing. That's channeling too. And through drawing mandalas, it's in particular technique that Carl Jung discovered. But it had been, of course, through Buddhist monks long time ago. It's basically a practice with drawing specifically. I'm not talking sun mandala or anything else. Drawing a circle, putting a dot that symbolizes self as ego self. And then anything that comes through doodling inside of it going to be your message as well. In that method, I've doodled lots of pictures of different aliens. And I knew immediately, I would feel the particular vibe, the who they are, who they're from. I even had Star of David, that is, there's this alien story about two triangle ships crossing, so they formed six-cornered star looking, which also represents Merkaba too, but it's also like how two ships had to turn in to pretend to be star temporarily. And not to lose track in here, I've also, in one gathering a long time ago, I have seen a bluish, whitish pole of energy standing, literally seeing it. And the confirmation I've got that it wasn't just myself, and it was in particular not something else, not an alien, but an angelic being. Another man who'd been seeing angels constantly, typically more than people since he was a child, confirmed exactly where he saw it and how he saw it. Before I gave any detail, we had complete match on our vision. So maybe just two of us, but
that's good enough. Brian, do you have any questions?
What is your biggest inspiration for the metaphysical for this? What drew you to here?
Before you even ended the sentence, I had the shortest answer ever. You are my inspiration. The fascination with human nature, with what makes us tick and who we are, and every time we seem to fail, make mistakes, and then angry self, happy self, all the shapes and forms. You is the answer. You and I and all of us is it.
That's nice. Any more questions, Brian? All right, let me do the commercial then. Tanya, we are a community of light workers, a human colony. I will give you a card so you know us and know where to find us. Here's the card. And it's my email here. And we are into channeling aliens and angelic beings and higher energies. So we give birth to many channelers now. We have more than 10 channelers, actively speaking. We have hangouts online where people meet and broadcast, several people online. So join us and show us our pictures, drawings of aliens. That would be very interesting too.
Okay.
And maybe you can listen to our languages and recognize something, and there should be some synchronicity to that. Not even synchronicity, so some synergy in that. So
yes, that's a key word, synergy.
Thank you very much, and it was fun. И спасибо большое за ваше интервью.
Также спасибо, thank you. Many and merry new beginnings in an everlasting, ever ongoing self-exploration, exploration what is.
Thank you.
It's a journey.